10 potential surprises that could happen at All In. Number 10, a new Bullet Club member. It has been quite a while since a brand new member was brought into the Bullet Club, with Cody and Marty Scurll's introductions being the most recent examples of wrestlers joining the prestigious group. There's going to be a very strong Bullet Club presence on the All In show, with all of the Being the Elite members competing in matches, so you can expect whatever storylines are taking place before then to unfold at All In. With the recent feuds within the Bullet Club, the Being the Elite section of the group may look to bring a new member into the fold, perhaps someone like Flip Gordon, or maybe someone totally new that fans haven't seen coming. Number 9, Rey Mysterio actually performs. He may have been announced for All In already, but being announced and actually taking part are two very different things, as people have already had to drop out of the show as other commitments have risen. There has been a lot of talk about Rey Mysterio and WWE lately, especially after making two appearances already this year, and wrestling fans are expecting to see him back full-time with the company in the near future. If he was to appear soon for WWE, which has been rumored, then that would likely rule him out of All In, and therefore actually seeing the veteran compete would be a shock. Number 8, a Goldust appearance. While this is very unlikely, as Goldust is under contract with WWE, seeing him appear at the All In event, even if it's just a shot of him in the crowd, would be a very cool moment, especially for Cody Rhodes. WWE wouldn't want Goldust to be doing too much on the show, and he's currently injured, which means wrestling is out of the equation, but just getting a glimpse of him would be a nice nod, and it isn't exactly going to hurt WWE in any way. Goldust could appear in the crowd, or even during a small backstage moment with Cody where they talk about Dusty Rhodes, and how proud he would have been is a moment that would be touching. Number 7, no mistakes. If you only ever watched WWE, this might seem like a strange thing to include, as seeing any form of mistake on Raw is incredibly rare. The production is always perfect, the camera angles are excellent, and the sound is always at a great level. The same cannot be said for independent shows, even for slightly bigger companies such as Ring of Honor or New Japan Pro Wrestling, where mistakes are common both in terms of production and the occasional botch inside the ring. With this being an independent show, the one being run by people who are wrestlers, not production experts, then seeing a full show without a single mistake would be a miracle. Number 6, Chris Jericho. While Goldust might be a name that will unlikely appear at the event, one WWE legend who certainly could show up is Chris Jericho, a current champion with New Japan, and someone who is working closely with Ring of Honor right now. Jericho has been popping up on the Being Elite YouTube channel, and Cody has spoken about a potential appearance from him before, which has led to some speculation that he might end up appearing in some capacity. While he is a WWE legend, and someone who often pops up for Vince McMahon's company, he has started doing a lot of other things with wrestling, and therefore, potentially seeing him appear on the biggest independent event in history. This could be interesting. Number 5, Cody becomes NWA champion. Cody Rhodes will be competing in one of All In's main event matches, where he'll be facing whoever is the NWA champion at that time, in what will be an NWA championship match featuring the historic title on such a big show. The title certainly has plenty of history with the Rhodes family, and seeing Cody win it, it would be very cool, and another clear indicator that Cody is one of the biggest stars in professional wrestling right now. However, because the NWA Championship is currently being toured around different promotions for the 10 Pounds of Gold YouTube channel, it would be a surprise for Cody to win, as he's more restricted as to where he can work. Number 4, Kenny Omega loses. His match for All In hasn't been announced yet, but Kenny Omega is going to be one of the biggest attractions of the entire show. His match for All In hasn't been announced yet, but Kenny Omega is going to be one of the biggest attractions of the entire show, and there's no doubt they're cooking up a big match for him for the event. However, no matter who he faces, and whether or not his IWGP Heavyweight Championship is on the line or not, seeing the cleaner lose would be a major surprise, as one of the biggest wrestlers in the world and the leader of the Bullet Club, this seems like a show he's guaranteed to win on. Even though they might decide Omega winning is too predictable, and therefore they will look to throw a surprise by having him lose, it is unlikely Cody and the Bucks will go that way, so anything other than an Omega win would be a shock. Number 3, Marty Scurll picks up a win. The All In show is obviously going to feature all of the Bullet Club talent in prominent matches, as they are the names who have really helped to sell the show, and that includes Marty Scurll, who is a big part of the group. Scurll's match for the event has already been announced, as he will be going one-on-one with Okada, one of New Japan's pro wrestling's biggest stars, who very rarely gets beaten by anybody. It'll be interesting to see how this match is booked, with Scurll and Okada being two of the biggest stars on the show, but seeing Marty gain a victory would be a massive surprise. Number 2, CM Punk. one of the biggest potential surprises that could take place at the All In event would see CM Punk make his long-awaited return to professional wrestling for the first time since he left WWE, and it's something that has been teased. It is highly expected that someone will be revealed as Bernard the Business Bear, and Punk could very much end up being that surprise. With his UFC career over, seeing Punk appear at the show to support his friends, the Young Bucks, would be an incredible moment. Cody and the Bucks don't want to advertise him as they wanted to sell the 10,000 seats without a name like Punk's, but having him appear as a surprise would be an amazing moment that nobody would ever forget, especially as it's happening in Chicago. Number 1. All In 2. The fact that Cody and the Young Bucks have been able to sell 10,000 seats for an independent wrestling show is an incredibly impressive feat that many people didn't expect them to be able to do. And now the pressure is on delivering a good quality event. With all three men being very smart business people, there's no doubt they must be thinking of possibly turning this into something more regular, or at least running another show in a new location. There would be no better time to drop the news that All In will be running a second show than right at the end of the night, after what will hopefully be a great event, revealing that All In 2 will be coming and providing a date, teasing things for the future.